A few minutes ago, in a living room, just to walk down the hallway. I figured I'd try mixing up a worn-out joke. But anyways, greetings, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to another edition of Classic Plastic. And now, I am still taking a bit of a break from doing any marathons, but I do figure that now that I've finally got a, you know what, last month, which you're seeing right here, I am going to start bringing in some console Star Wars games, which I originally planned on doing from a while back. So I'm going to do a little bit of catching up on some of those, well, mainly just do three of them for this period, along with a few other slew of other titles before doing my next marathon that I got planned. So yeah, we are going to go ahead and do Super Star Wars. That was redone by Code Mystics, of all people, I believe. And this was released around, well, this slightly filtered release, and by filtered I mean screen presentation, HD filter. But this game was originally released on the Super Nintendo back in 92. And this is when LucasArts was transitioning from their former title as Lucasfilm Games. And we're going to do this on easy because some of these games can be pretty hard. Especially the third game on the Super Nintendo, which we'll be doing at a much later time. Anyways, let's go ahead and get started. And trust me, compared to the NES, Famicom, and even the Game Gear version, which is based on the which is really just a port of the Famicom game, or not Famicom, but NES game, this was a much better attempt. And this is when George Lucas started implementing the original trilogy as episodes 4 through 6. That really did raise the eyebrow way back in the day. And plus, for a Super Nintendo title, you gotta love the rendition of John Williams' amazing score. Back then, this was definitely the game for Star Wars fans, and that was before the Lucasfilm really made their mark on Star Wars games for PC, or MS-DOS back then, I should say, with the release of Dark Forces, X-Wing, and Rebel Assault. The second and third games I mentioned, we will do at a much later time. Dark Forces I've already done a while back, so if you haven't watched it, check it out when you get a chance. It was definitely their answer to It Software's Doom back in the day. Alright, here we go. Before he gets a lightsaber. Although it's interesting, it's a dinky blaster rather than a rifle like he did in the movie. Because if you remember watching the movie where he, fought Tusken Raiders trying to find R2, he does carry a rifle. Alrighty. Yeah, these enemies can be annoying, but the thing is, they will drop a lot of health. Ugh. Those are Womp Rats. Now you know what they look like. And they look epic. I'll take that. Yes. It's a bit chaotic, but it's still somewhat manageable. As long as you manage to keep upgrading your blaster, you're gonna get by. there is lightsaber that you get, but it's not as good as it is in the later two games. There's a slight maybe inaccuracy here, and it's piss poor easy to beat. When you look at this, I'm not even really lined up, just standing shooting. Have gun, will shoot, as Deadpool would say. Still made it. And you do keep your blaster longer, which is super helpful. Also, oh yeah, I forgot about that. And the cool part is, if you bought this game on the PS4, it is a cross-buy purchase, which you'll get it for the Vita. However, I actually got this for free when I bought my first PS4 back in March of 2016. This is the one that came, and that is when it came with Battlefront, along with the other two PS2 Star Wars games, Jedi Starfighter, Bounty Hunter, and Razor's Revenge. Ooh. So, ow. Come on. Up there. Alright, just gotta wait for the right. There we go. It's all about timing. Oh, that was a health extension. Sorry. There will be more opportunities. And health extensions are basically lightsabers, pickups. As you can see, my health bar is really just that lightsaber. I mean, really good. I know I'm babbling about it constantly, but come on. It's playing Star Wars. How can you not like the music? This is where you want to watch your step. For that reason. Also, if debris flies, get the hell out of the way. Because if it hits you, it's gonna hurt. Alright, we're done. There we go. Yes. Faster and bounces everywhere. Center. Watch out for debris. Come on. There we go. Oh, come on. Damn it. There we go. What do I want to do? Spikes. I want to say that's instant death, but sometimes you actually can't survive. Just depends if the game feels like giving you a fighting chance or not. It's always been finicky like that. Ooh! Hold on. Keeps extending too. All right. Do not fall in that. You will die. All right. Oh no. Got it saved. Cut. Of course, my save had to take me all the way back here to the previous level. So now that I've saved up here, let's try again. Yeah. Excuse me. Extension and an analyzer. Thermal detonator. Screen nuke. You do have to push the button once you get it though. I was right effing there. I think it's about to blow it up. There we go. Ah! Get out of there. Job. still. That is definitely a sucker punch moment. Thank you. Oh, that's an arrow in the face. It's Alderaan, not Yavin. So yeah, they took some changes, but hey.
Use the Force, Luke.
I'm gonna be honest, the lightsaber here, that really is. Stick with the blaster. Ancient weapons and potent weapons are no match for a good blaster by your side, eh, kid? Forget, so we don't make that same damn mistake again. Watch the
Welcome.
Alright. There, we're gonna piss off this thing. You remember that chest, that gate that we claim on board the Millennium Falcon? That is the creature that she would use to win. I suggest a new strategy, buddy. Let the Wookiee win. Yeah. Cheap shot, asshole. I should note that this is the only version of Super Star Wars that has that save feature. So when we get to Super Empire Strikes Back and Return of the Jedi, it ain't gonna be as convenient, if you know what I mean. Now I guess the first thing we're taking out is that too. Thank you. This would have been easier to just avoid all that shit. Turrets. All right, we're practically back to where we left off because, god damn. Biggest lesson I can give you about this game is don't overwrite your save file, and more importantly, don't suck! Ugh. Oh boy. Cut. All right. Now we're where we left off. So just don't overwrite your save file. And shoot out those bombs.
Thank you.
So that'll be a good safe spot. Alright, round two. Again. We'll be right back. have many of them fly around with all of them. Conversation. Anyway, Luke, we're gonna have company! There we go.
Thank you.
Thank you. Definitely there.
Come on.
There we go. Comes the very final segment in the game.
They are targets.
you can shoot down the blasts I shoot at you. So there's that at least. Oh god. But it can get frantic real quick. Come on.
Stay on target.
I'm trying to, but... Moment of truth.
Use force, Luke.
That's what I was doing wrong. Alright.
Use the force, Luke.
There we go. I wasn't hitting the right button. Kaboom! Difficult, frantic, but overall, a fun game. That is the best way I can describe this game. Even before the save state implementing that was done in this version, it was still a fun game, even on the Super Nintendo way back in the day. Star Wars, or Super Star Wars, for the PS4, originally on the Super Nintendo. And yeah, you gotta love that looming image of Vader in the background. Which, by the way, I've already heard that James Earl Jones has now retired the voice and has given it to AI for archival purposes. Or for usage in later shows or whatnot, future projects. Although personally, I think Disney's done enough, they need to leave it the hell alone already. So, yeah, just you can chalk it up to me just putting up a burnout from Kathleen Kennedy. But that's as far as I'm gonna go. Anyway, guys, so we meet up again, probably after a good while. We're gonna hit up the original NES version of Super Mario Bros. 3. So, as always, guys, thank you so much for watching. Have a fantastic night, and enjoy the rest of the credits. See ya.